Do you have
think there, do you think there's any hesitation from Korean learners to learn English from other Korean learners? Maybe they're going to learn the wrong thing.
Oh.
Maybe they're going to get the wrong pronunciation.
This
they're
is really
hesitant
great question.
To,
wow, 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 wow.
to do that.
This is really great question. I'm so happy that you brought that up. Wow, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, I want to say two things, right? First of all, making a mistake is totally fine. But don't make a mistake, something that you're going to continue to do that for the rest of your life.
To make it a habit.
Make it a habit, yeah. Right? This is not good. But some Korean people, just because you know they're afraid to make mistakes, they don't say it. They don't open their mouths.
Mm.
They don't open their mouth. They shut their mouth up. They never say anything. You never get better. You get worse. At least those people who are having a conversation with Korean people, even though they have an accent, even though their pronunciation is not quite good, but they look confident. They seem to have a confidence in there. Sometimes, you know, it can be so stubborn and so even like they point out the mistakes that native English speakers make. Oh, I'm right. Okay. I am native English speaker. I'm a teacher. You gotta listen. No. Yeah. I'm just kidding. But anyway, yeah. So, I think it's much better than not speaking at all. Makes sense, right?
Yeah.
So, having a conversation with Korean people with a rule that every single person has to speak English and you're racking your brain. You're squeezing your brain. You take something out and you are making a sentences. That means your brain is working.
Yeah.
Yeah, your brain is working. You're getting better, right? Your brain muscle is working. English muscle is working. So, it's much better than saying nothing, waiting for the right time. When's the right time? Let me ask you. When's the right time?
The right time was 10 seconds ago before the conversation passed you by.
Yeah. And on top of that, writing, like maybe if you're waiting for the right time to speak English perfectly, then you start having a conversation. Then you know what? You know what? And maybe it's going to be 20 years later. It's going to be 30 years later. Maybe not. Maybe, you know, like that's not going to happen for the rest of your life. So open your mouth and have a conversation is totally fine. You know, before I said having a basic foundation, right? Having basics down, that matters a lot because you make less mistakes.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? So I'm telling you that make mistakes is fine, but if you think that you are not ready because, you know, you don't know grammar, you don't know basics, then I think you have to do that. You have to study.
Right?
Yeah. But it shouldn't take up that long time. It shouldn't be like a year. It shouldn't be like, you know, 2 years or 3 years, 5 years. Some people, they study English by themselves, right? For 5 years, six years,
yeah.
7 years,
wow.
Thinking that I'm going to make it perfect. I'm going to get this, you know, basics down. I'm going to get this basics down. Nuance 덕분에 영어 공부, whatever. you don't have to do that, right? Once you get the basics down within like 2 months and 3 months, right? You study hard, you know, 2 or 3 months. And after that, the next step is, yeah, you gotta use it.
Yeah.
You gotta use it. Okay. Here's another one that I want to mention. Having a conversation with Korean people, only if you do that, then maybe that might be a bit of a mistake. I want you to be exposed to native English speaker at least every once in a while. Like, you know, once a month. Possibly, if you have to pay for that to get that kind of feedback from the native speaker, I think it's your money well spent. So feedback matters a lot. In order to get to the next level, feedback matters.
Like a check-in almost.
Yeah, check-in almost, right? Nowadays, you don't have to pay a lot of money, right? There's a lot of native speakers here in South Korea. And also, you don't have to meet that face-to-face. You don't have to meet them in person.
Mm.
There's a lot of great online teachers, right? There's a lot of online platforms like a Cambly or iTalki or, you know, whatever. And you can use that. You can have a conversation. You can ask them, hey, did I do something wrong? Right? So you can ask them, when you make mistakes, correct me. You tell them.
Yeah.
If you don't want them to stop you right away because, you know, you're in the flow of having a conversation, tell them. Just write things down when I have a conversation and then after I'm done and let them summarize what kind of mistakes I'm making.
Hmm.
I made. Then learn from that. And then you apply that. Next time when you have a conversation with your Korean friends, you do that. Then I think, you know, it's getting better and better and better. And now you're confident. Now your sentences, less mistakes, right? Better sentences, right? It's getting better and better and better.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, just like you said before, you just have to get out there and don't be afraid to make mistakes. If I could say there's one thing that's held me back on my own learning of a second language is I still have some of that apprehension to just go out there and speak.
Oh, yeah.
I have a friend, she's a Japanese friend living in Canada.
Yeah.
She's also learning Korean, and she speaks with confidence. She's not afraid to make mistakes. She makes a lot of mistakes, but you can understand what she's saying.
Yeah,
you know, I thought she knew a lot more than I did. When I dug into it, I realized, I know so much more grammar than her. I know so much more vocabulary than her. I'm way more advanced than her, but yet she can jump out there into a conversation.
Yeah,
she can be the one to put herself forward, and it looks like I'm the one who's the basic
one. And I also feel like Korean people, sometimes they can be very judgmental.
Mm.
Not only to themselves, but other people as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, you know, when you watch videos made by Korean people, right? You know, Korean English learners, right? Whatever. You know, I master English, right? You know, my English is pretty good. You know, whatever, right? They talk about it. And all the time, you can see some, comments, vicious comments that, hey, your English is not that good. You know, I don't think your English is perfect.
Yeah.
You know, things like that. What is being perfect? There is nothing perfect. Even Joe, I think he makes some mistakes along the way, right?
I think I've made about four or five at least in this conversation.
Yeah. But anyway, people make mistakes. I make mistakes, you know? Like, I can see so many people making mistakes. But the thing is, you know, it's totally fine. Once you make a mistake, you scratch that, and then you create another sentence, right? You know, you correct that. You accept that. Trying to make it perfect, trying to sound like a native English speaker, trying to sound like Obama, trying to sound like whatever, whoever you respect, I think it's totally fine. You're trying to be like that person, the way they speak, it's good. But the thing is, you're not that person. Don't lose your identity. You know, you're you. I'm me. So, when I was younger myself, when I visualized younger myself, I wanted to hear from people that, oh, Luke, you know, your English is fantastic. You sound like a native English speaker. And then that's when I got really pumped up. And then I was like, wow, jumping, you know, I made it happen. But, I mean, that was why. I started to ask myself, why? Why? Why does that make happy? English.